We're checking out if there are any bees in there.
It's a bee hotel for the bees to lay their eggs in.
These bees like to live alone, and that's what this bee hotel is made for.
This is the second year that these students will be hosting a bee hotel in their schoolyard. But they're hoping to help spread the word to homeowners as part of the BIMBY project.
The Bees in My Backyard project, we're riffing on the idea of NIMBYism, which is not in my backyard, but we want bees in backyards. We're looking to get cavity nesting bees and do a wild bee census of cavity nesting bees, the bees that nest in these sorts of tubes. And it's a project with the David Suzuki Foundation in partnership with the University of Toronto Scarborough. And so the researchers at U of T, they're going to be taking data from each of these bee hotels that will be set up in 150 yards and schools across the city.
These hotels will not only help increase the wild bee population, but also assist researchers on gathering important information about the decline of all bees.
I mean, they are part of the solution, you know, and when they learn about what they can do, they bring that home to their parents. They talk about it with their parents. The conversations are engaging, and that's what starts a whole new thing.
The homes need to be within the core of Toronto, and they're still looking for 50 more households to participate.
Across the city, there will be 150 different participants that will be submitting citizen science, so information every 2 weeks, to the researchers at University of Toronto.
For those who worry about having bees in their backyard, organizers say risks are minimal.
There's a difference between wasps and honeybees and wild bees, and so our project is focused on wild bees. And these are mostly solitary bees. They're vegetarians. They don't show up at your barbecue like the wasps. So these are solitary critters. Most of them don't have stingers that would pierce our skin.
I think by putting this bee hotel here, it'll attract a lot of bees, which we also planted flowers here, which will also help the bees. So that's how we're contributing.
If you would like to be part of the BIMBY project, you can go to our website, citynews.ca/extras, for the link to register. In Toronto, Audra Brown, City News.